If you don't like a film, you say it is a lousy film, or that you don't like it, and the matter ends there. In my films, I have found that people who have not liked them are still quite shaken up by them. I have found them to get angry and disturbed and walk out of my movies, saying it's an antisocial film. I could see that the film has disturbed them to a certain extent, even annoyed them. This kind of reaction could not have been evoked by the standard Indian film. Even the critics who criticize me more than my films, they write that stuff, and I feel that possibly I've made a point somewhere, somewhat differently and effectively perhaps. Otherwise, how is it that these people are provoked in such a manner? And this goes to prove that this kind of film, if we can create conditions whereby this genre of film continues to pour in one after the other, we'll be able to create a climate which will help the movement to grow and help develop a radical cultural climate. Thus spoke Mrinal Sen, the legendary filmmaker from Bengal, when asked whether his films are successful in building a radical climate among the audience. The crux and importance of Mrinal Sen in context of Indian cinema could not have been better expressed. Mrinal Sen, the pioneer and strongest voice in cinema for the people of India. He continuously probed on the social fabric of the country and the socio-economic fallacies in his often experimental style. Podatik, if we may say, referring to the name of one of his celebrated films. Mrinal Sen has been the true foot soldier of Indian cinema, the street fighter. And we at Filmcopath are here today to celebrate the journey of our beloved filmmaker on his 98th birth anniversary. As someone belonging to the golden trio of Bengali cinema, that is with Satyajit and Hrithik Ghatak, one must say that Mrinal didn't have the right start to his filmmaking. Charlie Chaplin was one of his earliest inspirations, while his interest in filmmaking came from Rudolf Arnheim's Film as Art, a book on film aesthetics. In 1955, Sen had his first feature released, Raat Bhor, starring the Bengali matinee idol Uttam Kumar, which failed in all terms. Neelakasher Niche, released in 1959, Sen's second film, and the first film of independent India that got banned. The film, set in 1930s Kolkata, was not allowed to release as it demonstrated how the bourgeois class didn't have enough empathy for the have-nots living under the same blue sky, that is, Neelakasher Niche in Bengali. It was the story of Wang Lu, a Chinese street hawker in Kolkata, and his brotherly bonding with a Bengali housewife. The film imbibed certain communist ideology that the then Nehruvian socialist regime was not comfortable with. Interestingly, the film did not only narrate the struggle of Indians under the British rule or the class barriers in India, it spoke about other have-nots in China and the Chinese struggle under attack from Japan. Mrinal was a voice of resistance for the poor and deprived beyond barriers of border. Hence, Neelakasher Niche was not a success either. And it was Baishe Srabon, his third feature, that finally fetched him some acclaim. It was his first film that went to a foreign film festival, the London Film Festival. When the Bengali Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore died in 1941, massive crowds gathered outside his ancestral Calcutta mansion, hoping to catch a last glimpse. The roads were crammed, and even Tagore's son Rathindranath could not reach the cremation ghat to light his father's pyre. The ghat had been cordoned off for a week in preparation for the funeral. But once the fire was lit, people broke in, looking for bones and other remains. The body wasn't yet burnt, and the mourners were scavenging through the ashes, screaming and cursing. Mrinal, then a student, was within the crowd outside the funeral when he spotted a man standing with a child in his arms, his own wrapped in a milk white towel. He came to cremate the child and was caught in a cruel situation. Suddenly, the crowd broke from all directions with the cordon totally broken. Mrinal lost sight of the man and his child. 20 years later, Mrinal had made Baishe Shravan. On the backdrop of the 1943 Bengal famine, and interestingly named the film as the date of Tagore's death, Baishe Shravan, the 22nd day of the Shravan month of the Bengali calendar. It was the story of how a loving couple ends up pitted against each other when crisis strikes. The tragedy of the famine, implied in the film through a scene of villagers queuing up to buy rice, is overshadowed by the souring of the couple's relationship, like Tagore's passing paled for seeing a father carrying his dead child in the crowd. It is since Baishe Shravan that Sen took over the role of a socially engaged storyteller, who reported those untold stories of independent India which his peers chose to gloss over, if not completely neglect. Sen's 1965 film Akash Kushum, inspired by the jump cuts and freeze frames of Francois Truffaut, had mixed critical reactions. And perhaps the most vocal critic of the film was Satyajit Ray. Interestingly, Akash Kushum had Soumitra Chatterjee, the regular lead actor of Satyajit, as its lead Ajoy, a desperate dreamer of sky-high dreams who resorts to lies and quick-fix approaches in his attempt to break free from social and economic barriers. Satyajit questioned the contemporaneity in a long-running exchange of letters between him and Sen on the Statesman editorial. "A crow film is a crow film is a crow film," said Ray in a savage attack on Sen and Akash Kushum. Well, Sen wasn't a filmmaker only. He was like a historian who, like an activist, was recording his time. From the birth of the lost Bengali after independence in Baishe Shravan or Akash Kushum to the birth of the Marxist Bengalis of the 70s in his Calcutta trilogy to the loss and confusion around Bengali ideologies with the fall of the Berlin Wall in Mahaprithivi. And from that archival point of view, Ajoy in Akash Kushum was no aberration but a reality of the Bengali middle class of the 60s. And happens to be one of our favorite Mrinal Sen films. Odia film Matiro Monisha followed Akash Kushum. And then came Sen's most celebrated film Bhuvan Shom in Hindi. That won him 3 national awards: Best Director, Best Actor for Utpal Dutt, and Best Film Bhuvan Shom. A story of an honest Indian bureaucrat brought up in the best British traditions, who lives by a very strict code, a code that allows for no deviation. And yet, by the end of the film, he has been corrupted under the influence of a simple village girl who helps him understand and access things as they are until he is willing to let them be. It was one of the first time an Indian filmmaker satirized bureaucracy, and that too with such effectiveness. In Sen's own words, the film pokes fun at the immorality which dominates our society, determines it, and continues to build on it, and thus is a predecessor of the much-acclaimed Newton by Amit Masurkar. The much-acclaimed Calcutta trilogy followed Bhuvan Shom. Interview in 1971, Calcutta 71 in 1972, and Podatik in 1973. It was a more political phase when Sen, heavily influenced by the European New Wave, was often referred to as the Bengali Godard for his jump cuts, freeze frames, titular cards, or breaking of the fourth wall. Actor Ranjit Mallick is named Ranjit Mallick in the film Interview, where in one of the sequences, he transcends from real to real self and starts talking to the audience, talks about Sen the director and even his co-actors.
আমার নাম রঞ্জিৎ মল্লিক, আমি একটা সাপ্তাহিক পত্রিকায় কাজ করি, থাকি ভবানীপুরে। ভীষণ আনইভেনফুল লাইফ মশাই আমার, আর এইটাই মৃণাল সেনের, ওই যে ভদ্রলোক ছবি টবি করেন, ওনার খুব ভালো লেগে গেল। আমাকে বললেন ঠিক আছে, তোমাকে ওই সকাল থেকে সন্ধ্যা পর্যন্ত ক্যামেরা নিয়ে তাড়া করবো। দেখো, আচ্ছা বলুন তো মশাই, আপনারা কোনো মানে আছে?
Interview was a satire where a man loses his job because he cannot afford to get hold of a suit on his interview day. A stylized depiction of our Victorian morals and colonial hangovers where the city of Kolkata featured as a character. Sen loved his city, referred to it as his El Dorado. And when the city was going through its most terrible phase, with daily killings around inter-party clashes between the Naxalites and the other communist factions, Sen thought it would be his responsibility to bring back the attention to the common ills, the fundamental disease of poverty, in his angry depiction of realism in Calcutta 71. You see, he was a filmmaker, not driven by his wishes and fantasies of making art. Art was a tool. Cinema was a responsibility of Sen, the fighter whose form of cinema differed as per the conditions of his city and country, always wanting to define history and put it in the right perspective. No wonder Podatik, his next, was a call for self-criticism for the left parties, who were losing perspective and were in disarray by then. It was a satire on the established way of going anti-establishment and falling a victim to its own. A theme beautifully represented in the very contemporary Yorgos Lanthimos's Lobster, which Mrinal Sen had explored 48 years back.
Nothing grows in vacuum. Nothing drops on vacuum. Nothing happens in void. So what happens to me? I am a social being. I react to the situations around me, and that is how I start thinking. It starts trickling off only after I react to a certain situation. That is why, you know, whatever you try to say, either in terms of cinema or in any creative art, a little bit of yourself is bound to come.
Predictably, a chorus of voices attacked Mrinal Sen. He had shaken both the left wing and the right wing, but none could deter him from agitating the audience. Shake them out of their comfort zone and react. Be the farce corporate setting in chorus, attack on colonialism and hierarchy in Mrigoya, or anti-feudalist stand in his Telugu venture, Oka Uri Katha. Sen attacked with undisguised horror and anger the poverty, the exploitation and the inherent hypocrisy of Indian society. As critic Derek Malcolm mentions, in Okaler Sandhane, Sen experimented with the film within a film structure. Set in 1981, the premise was that of a film crew in a village to shoot the story of the 43 famine, only to realize that an acute food crisis exists even at the present time. The past walked into the present as the film progressed, as real and real clashed. The next phase of Mrinal Sen was more directed to social critique than political critique, gender imbalance and its impact on middle class values in Ek Din Pratidin, or the entrenched bourgeois values and materialistic privilege that lead to indifference, discrimination and insularity in Kharij or Ek Din Achanak.
এটা আপনারা সিনেমা বলেন নাকি? এটা আমার কথা, আপনার কথা।
Does that mean Sen was always a critic and no romantic? Well, hardly so. As he mentions in his biography, at a time he was courting his future wife Geeta, who happened to be his regular collaborator as well, he was all into the book A Case for Communism. He carried the book with him even on a date with Geeta on the Bali Bridge. Young Mrinal had a sudden urge to hold Geeta's hand. The first time for him, and in his haste and awkwardness, A Case for Communism slipped from his hand and fell into the river below. Love eclipsed the manifesto. Even when he was shocked by the way Ray critiqued his filmmaking from time to time, Mrinal always acknowledged Satyajit's contribution to Indian cinema. Be through his tributes in his own films like Bhuvan Shom or Interview, or in personal life. Mrinal, whose films always featured in the main competition section of Cannes, if it made it to the lineup, moved Khandahar to uncertain regard sidebar to make way for Rai's Ghore Baire, which an ailing, just out of hospital Rai had finished in time for the festival. Only a romantic could have done that. When Smita Patel and Shabana Azmi both wanted to act with Sen and requested him for roles, Sen dropped them letters saying that he cannot cast both of them together. They are both great actresses and he would start with one and take the other. And then deliberately dropped Smita's letter to Shabana's address and vice versa. You know, our guerrilla fighter was also a child at heart. No wonder Sen negated Godard's idea that cinema can act like a gun. That is too romantic an expression, said Mrinal. You cannot topple a government or a system by making one Potemkin. You can't do that with 10 Potemkins. All you can do is create an environment in which you can discuss a society that is growing undemocratic and fascistic. Not a gun which has an immediate effect, but a foot soldier or a street fighter, as we keep on mentioning in this tribute, who recorded the chronicles of dissent of our society in our cinema.
Jago, 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 sarvohara, anushan bandhi krito dar. Shromik diyate aaj sara, uthiyate mukti rasar.